gosh, I love this. The rain is not keeping people away. I always say, rain or shine, we're going to do this. Hi, Facebook. Two of the Facebook audience are here live with us. So I said at the end of last week that I was really excited I was going to have family in town. So my sister Diane and my brother-in-law Kevin are here. I know, right? The guys are most excited because she brought the gift of Anyway, it's these guys discovered
the commercial bit.
Right. I know. Thank you, Vanna. So when we last summer when we went to Iowa, they discovered this bug stuff that's made in Iowa and they love it. So anyway, all right. So this week we're going a little country. I think I'm going back to my roots a little bit somehow, I guess. Plus, I was trying to make my brother-in-law happy. So, we're just gonna kick it right off. Take this job and shove it. I ain't working here no more. Wanda left, took all the reasons I was working for. On the bass on that one. Yeah. All right. So this next one, I'm going to take a deep breath and we're going to see what happens. I was toting my pack along the long, dusty Winnemucca Road. When along came a semi with a high and canvas covered load. If you're going to Winnemucca Mac with me, you can ride. So I climbed into the cab and then I settled down inside. He asked me if I'd seen a road with so much dust and sand. And I said, listen, I've traveled every road in this here land. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the deserts bare, man. I breathe the mountain air, man. Travel, I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere. I've been to Reno, Chicago, Fargo, Minnesota, Buffalo, Toronto, Winslow, Sarasota, Wichita, Tulsa, Ottawa, Oklahoma, Tampa Bay, Panama, Ottawa, La Paloma, Bangor, Baltimore, Salvador, Amarillo, Tokyo, Vancouver. That one was thrown in there specifically because between the travel he has always done for work and the fact that my brother-in-law loves nothing more than to get on a motorcycle and ride, he quite literally, I think, has been everywhere. So, and now
also, because I played Johnny Cash.
You did play Johnny Cash. Doesn't he look like Johnny Cash?
Just like him. Great.
Oh my goodness. Oh my that's actually a true statement though.
Right, it was an understudy issue. There was a COVID and there's a fall on the stage. And so they threw me in. I was the black Johnny Cash.
I think he would have loved that.
Well, his first wife was black. Who knew? I did not know that.
I didn't know that either.
Yeah.
Huh.
And he was part Cherokee.
Right. So I was not the first black Johnny Cash. He was.
That's hilarious. Okay, so this next one, little Tom T. Hall, How I Got to Memphis. And I first really encountered this song from a TV show that this was used in the show. And I just, you know, a little hats off to all the music supervisors out there who are always just finding these gems of songs and either bringing them back to us again or introducing them to us. So music supervisors. All right, now we're going not country at all, but just one that we like to do, because I like to watch Galen's hair grow towards the end of this song. This is our arrangement of 38 Special, Hold On Loosely. All right. Okay. So I need to do a little technical changing on my iPad here. So while I'm doing that, I do want to mention, though, we have a candidate for county commissioner in our midst. And anytime somebody is, and she has been serving on school board for four years, yes, for the last 4 years. And unfortunately, and I think I'm going to go ahead and say this, the reason she is not running for city council again, I think, is partly because it's gotten so far one direction that there is just no doing anything and making a difference there. And so rather than giving up, she is running for county commissioner, Steph Walker. So thank you so much, Stephanie. And we will be very lucky to have her as a county commissioner. So. All right, so this one we're going to do a little Randy Travis. This is actually a new to us song. It's one I've wanted to cover for a while, and I think it's because this is Forever and Ever, Amen. And I have to say that the phrase in the middle of it, as long as old men sit and talk about the weather, and as long as old women sit and talk about old men, that for whatever reason has always been like my favorite part of the whole song. So here we go. Travis. All right. Now Brian's coming back. Oh, now I got to get back to where we're supposed to be. There we go. Yeah. love country music?
Yeah. Sure.
He's not a country guy. All right, sorry about that. Sometimes I just gotta wet your whistle. All right, so now we're gonna go to church. That's Maren Morris' song that I only know about because of my big sister. So we were on a little sister road trip, and she said to Linda and myself, listen to this one. I love this one. So, and now I love it too. All right. Right? That's my church right there. All right. So now we're going to do the chicks. Where's Coleman when we need her? She is. So this is a chick's tune that we have done before for all of you, but it's one we love to do. There's Your Trouble. Like a ring, like a diamond ring, token of true love. of trouble.
I know, but do you know that Natalie Merchant song, Wonder? It's not in this key, but it's the same progression. Natalie Merchant Day.
Oh. Okay.
It was a sad
right, next
note.
Season, because we're running out of time. And you only have one more with us.
Oh, right.
Right? You weren't with us last Sunday.
Oh, right. Never mind.
Yeah.
But we should still do it.
We should. We should. Well, maybe we could do it next. We might be able to work it out for next week. Yeah.
Jim would like her. Oh, those freedom next week. Then it's Jim.
Yeah. So, yes, but I agree.
It's a great chord progression.
I know, that's a fun chord. It is. It's a fun chord. These are weird musician things. It's a fun. But from There's Your Trouble, you get to Jolene.
Right.
There's Your Trouble. So. About that song that it just is so popular. Galen talks about it all the time too. He's like, play a gig, play Jolene, and everybody loves
it. Everybody happy. God bless Dolly.
Okay.
All right. So now. Sorry, I feel like there's a lot of condensation on the mic. That's okay, right? Electrocute myself. All right. So, from this progression. So There's Your Trouble, gets you to Jolene, and then that kind of gets you to being a truck driving woman, I think.
Go.
Maybe. I know, we've got a musical in the making. When you see me on the highway, you nearly shift your load. Take another look, good buddy, that's when you nearly leave the road. Ain't you never seen a truck driving Walmart? 90 pounds of fire in a 5-foot brake. So that's Barbara Dane, for those of you who haven't heard that one before, heard me talk about her. Barbara Dane was a blues singer in the, she probably started in the 40s?
40s, probably, early 50s,
maybe. Maybe, yeah. And probably could have been pretty famous by industry standards, but she chose to become an activist and get very involved with the plight of the working people, and thus a lot of her songs are about working class people. So anyway, Barbara Dane, check her out. All right, let's see. Oh, Brian's gonna lead us a little bit, but we're all gonna be involved in this.
Yay.
Yay.
We're all community here.
We are. This a little, it is. Yeah. It's the people. Oh, and speaking of the people, Brian Whitted, Galen Hunsucker, oh. Mitch Hebert, Vince Stout.
Back there hiding.
Yes, so we are going to lean on you, Brian.
In our lives, we all have pain.
Yeah. Thank you, Brother Bill. May he rest in peace. One of them we lost during COVID. In fact, we lost Bill Withers. That was the week we started Sunday Songs. And we sang Lean on Me at the very first Sunday Songs.
And Tom Pollock was
here. They were here, and they're here now. Ah, it's a full circle moment.
Or they're like, learn some new songs.
It's been 5 years. Learn some new songs. Oh, my goodness. Well, we are coming, drawing close to the end of our set. We're going to do a couple of originals. First, we're going to do what I believe my sister has said is her favorite song that I've written, Little Yellow Plums, which, if the album ever comes out, is the title track. I was walking the beach, spread my wings, trying to let go of all those things tie you down and hold you back. I will set my sights on something good, and the answer came from out of the woods. You know those little yellow plums, they make me happy. Little yellow plums, they make me happy. Come with me to the
Yellow bombs.
the last song of the night, but I have forgotten to say that the guys love your applause and love your love, but they love your tips too.
Tips are love.
Tips are love. Oh, Galen. That was good.
Right.
That was good. So, and I wanna make sure, Vince, for everybody here, I think for Facebook, you've actually been able to see Vince fairly well, but for everybody here, hiding. So, yeah. So we're going to close out with, oh, I didn't do the Venmo. We do take tips at Venmo, and we use Galen's Venmo, which is at Galen-Hunsucker, which is at Galen-Hunsucker. Don't add that last part or it'll go to somebody else.
Don't add the last part.
All right. This this last one we're gonna do for you is called Love of My Life.
Rockabilly Central, baby.
We will be back next week and the week after next. Be safe, be well, and can't wait to see you next week. Thank you for coming out.
What?
Next week's free. Next week is Freedom Week. Come and find out what that means.
Right. I won't be free.
All right. Bye, Facebook.